Make sure to look through the camera.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's often not understood the extent to which policies are informed by social data, how much social measurement and social policy depend on large-scale surveys, really basic kinds, from census data saying which kinds of people are living where, what is income inequality like, what is health like, who is in prison, who is in trouble right now. These things, if we don't have accurate ways of assessing that or trustworthy ways of assessing that, we, I think, are going to have real trouble making informed decisions and wise decisions. So in my own lab research, the work I've carried out with Fred Conrad from the University of Michigan, we've been doing a number of studies of interaction in standardized survey interviews. We've carried out studies trying to understand how precisely people will answer and how much they'll disclose when they're answering survey questions, including some really embarrassing ones, on their iPhones, either texting with a human interviewer or texting with an automated interviewing system. People disclose more to a computer than to a person. So I have a really strong sense of mission that accurate social measurement is something we should all be working towards. That actually providing your anonymized data and consenting to provide your anonymized data might be a really good thing, might be necessary. So I think the fact that we have these new forms of interaction that change social presence, that take away the feeling of really being there with your partner and take away time pressure, may well, in some cases, make people feel more comfortable, make people feel more private, more willing to say stuff they wouldn't have said otherwise.